Hello. Now, in this next module, the MP curve, which stands for monetary policy curve, we're going to attempt to model how the Federal Reserve makes their decisions and then incorporate that with the IS curve to come up with a ISMP model that describes essentially it's a Keynesian model, but with inflation on the vertical axis. Okay, here's the outline for the MP curve. First, we're gonna go through the neutral real interest rate or natural interest rate, and the different types of stances that our Federal Reserve has, from expansionary to contractionary, and what the possible instruments there are to carry out their stances. Then we'll go through what is the usual choice of their policy instrument to carry out their policies. And then we'll go through the monetary transmission mechanism, which is how does changing the money supply affect the economy? We know that it works. It does affect the economy. At least in the short run, it affects output. In the long run, it probably affects inflation too, but exactly how? So everyone agrees it has an effect on the economy, but no agreement really on just how it affects the economy. Then we'll go through how the central bank affects the real interest rate. It's easy to affect the nominal interest rate by buying and selling bonds, but how does that affect the real interest rate in the economy? Then we'll go through the monetary policy curve. And we'll create that curve, show you how it works, combine it with the IS curve, and then show how that creates the downward sloping aggregate demand curve. And what happens when, what makes this curve shift? And what causes a movement along the curve? So there's a difference here, as usual, between a shift and a movement. Then we'll take a look at the aggregate demand curve and look at that as far as what causes a shift and what causes a movement on the curve. Okay, so first the natural rate or the neutral rate. If I redraw the savings and investment diagram here. We have savings and investment and the real interest rate on the y-axis and the quantity of savings and investment down here. At potential, where output is equal to potential, where we're on the edge of the PPF, is where we'll be in the long run. In the long run, the interest rate here should be at this equilibrium, we'll call R star. So R star is the long run equilibrium interest rate. It's where savings is equal to investment. And it's that long run rate that what the rate would be if the Federal Reserve or the central bank wasn't sticking their fingers into the economy and manipulating interest rates. If they just laid off and didn't do anything, what would the interest rate be? That's our star. That's the natural rate of interest. Now, of course, the Federal Reserve is always sticking their fingers in and trying to manipulate the economy for the purpose of stabilizing the economy and stabilizing the business cycle, as they're required to do by their mandate from Congress. So we can look at the different types of stances they have, from on one side being contractionary and on the other side being expansionary. So a contractionary policy is generally referred to as a tight policy. And an expansionary policy is referred to as an easy policy or a loose policy, or more recently, the term now, in the last 20 years or so, has been an accommodative policy. Two C's, two M's. and expansionary policy will stimulate the economy. So they want to stimulate they move towards an expansionary policy, and this can lead to inflation down the road. So this can lead to more inflation. And it works by increasing aggregate demand. And the way it works is because the money supply, here's the nominal money supply, divided by the price level, that's the real money supply. When that changes, it changes interest rates. So we have the real money supply affects nominal interest rates. So for example, the money supply goes up, the real money supply goes up, the nominal interest rate falls. So this will be a nominal interest rate. And we know that from looking at Keynes's model, his liquidity preferences model. Now tight or contractionary policy is generally done to control inflation. And the way it's thought to work is by decreasing aggregate demand. And neutral will be somewhere in the middle where they're not trying to stimulate the economy and they're not trying to contract it or control inflation. Now we can also think of these policy stances in terms of the neutral rate of interest. So an expansionary policy is going to bring down interest rates. So in terms of this model up here that we were looking at, if the interest rate in the economy, R, is down here, less than R star because of the Fed, we can look at that as an easy monetary policy. So down here, let's see. If R is less than R star, then what's going to happen is it's going to lead to more investment. Investment will go up and stimulate the economy. If R set by the Federal Reserve is higher than R star, then we can look at that as a tight monetary policy. Tight policy. So if R is greater than R star, that's going to make investment fall, decrease C plus I plus G, and aggregate demand would fall, shift to the left. A neutral stance where they're not trying to do either one would be setting the interest rate right equal to R star, what it would be without the Fed intervening.